Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about arterial pressure pulsations. It will cover topics like different types of pressure and transmission of pressure waves along the arterial tree. But before we start any discussion, get one thing very clear. The pressure pulses are not the same as the flow of blood. Blood flow is the actual flow of blood. But pressure pulses are the waves of pressure that travel through the blood. It's like sound waves. If you know about sound waves, as sound moves, the air molecules maintain their overall position. But the wave of sound moves ahead through them. The pressure waves in the arterial tree are something similar. The blood remains static, but the wave of pressure passes through it. Okay, yeah, actually the blood is also flowing, as shown here. So both things are happening simultaneously in the same system. But showing them together will make you dizzy, let alone understand the concept. So for ease of understanding, I am showing them separately. Now, if this basic is clear to you, let's focus on pressure pulses and discuss their features. In this diagram, the early portion represents the aorta, the end portion represents capillaries, and the mid portion represents the entire arterial hierarchy in between. The pressure is generated by the heart during systole. The blood that enters the aorta during this tends to push all the existing blood in vessels forwards. But due to the inertia of the blood, it does not move suddenly. So initially, the incoming blood causes a rise in pressure in the aorta. Then this pressure spreads in the entire arterial tree like a wave, much faster than the blood itself. So this is how a pressure wave, or pressure pulse, travels along the arterial tree. As it travels, it causes fluctuation in blood pressure. The upper pressure during this is called systolic pressure. At the aorta, it's about 120 millimeters of mercury. The lower pressure is the diastolic pressure. It's about 80 millimeters of mercury. And the difference between the two is pulse pressure. As you can calculate, it's 40 millimeters of mercury. This pulse pressure depends on two factors: stroke volume and distensibility of the arteries. More stroke volume means more blood is getting pushed into the arteries with each heartbeat. This increases the pulse pressure. And if the vessel is more distensible, it dampens the pressure by getting distended more. So the more the distensibility, the less the pulse pressure. So this was about pulse pressure, which is for the fluctuation in pressure. But can you guess what would be the mean or average pressure that the arteries experience? Well, we are tempted to think that it's 80 plus 120 divided by 2 equals 100, aren't we? But this is wrong. The reason is that you are not taking time into account. This graph shows aortic pressure over time. Note that the arteries spend less time in high systolic pressure and more time in diastolic pressure, which is low. The exact mean arterial pressure is the area under the curve spread out evenly. As more time is spent at low pressure, the average is closer to low pressure. Normally, it is about 95 millimeters of mercury. During exercise, the duration of diastole gets relatively shorter. So the mean arterial pressure moves towards systolic pressure. So this was all about mean arterial pressure. Now come back to the arteries. As the pressure wave travels from the aorta to subsequent vessels, the pressure causes distension of respective vessels. In fact, it's these distensions that you feel when you examine the radial pulses at the wrist. Okay, if these big obvious things are clear to you, let's dive deeper into very small details about the pulses. Here we will talk about the velocity and damping of the pulses. I am already showing both of these in a very subtle way. If you have sharp observation, you might have already noticed this. But if you didn't, let me make it clear to you. First, let's talk about velocity. If you observe carefully, the velocity is low near the aorta and high at the small arteries. The velocity at any vessel depends on the stiffness of that vessel wall. If the vessel is less stiff, or in other words, more compliant, more energy is lost in the distension of the vessel. So the wave slows down. On the other hand, in a stiff vessel, no such loss occurs. So the velocity increases. In general, the stiffness of vessels increases as we go from aorta to smaller arteries. So the velocity increases as we go from the aorta to the periphery. Or in simple words, the pulse speeds up as it enters stiffer and stiffer vessels. And don't forget that these pressure pulsations are passing through actually flowing blood. In general, the pressure waves travel much faster than the flow of blood at all the segments. Even at the aorta, where they are relatively slow, they travel about 15 times faster than the flow of blood. So this was about the velocity. Finally, let's talk about the damping, or fading out, of pulsation. Again, if you are observing carefully, the pulsation is fading out as we go from the aorta to the capillary. In our earlier discussion, you might have observed that I showed less fluctuation in meters close to smaller arteries, as compared to more fluctuation in meters near the aorta. This is because of the damping, or fading, of the pulse. In fact, by the time they reach the capillary, they fade out almost completely. So the pulsation at the capillary is near zero. There are two reasons behind this damping. We have already touched upon one reason earlier. It's distensibility of the vessels. As the wave travels, some energy is lost in causing the distension of the vessel. This makes the waves weaker. And another reason is resistance. See, although in a small amount, some blood does need to move forward to transmit the pressure to the next segment. This movement of the blood is opposed by the resistance. So indirectly, the resistance also dampens the pressure wave. Because of this, the pressure waves are strongest at the aorta and progressively become weaker as we move towards the capillary. So this was all about the transmission of pressure pulses from the aorta to the peripheral arteries. Now let's have a quick summary. Pressure waves travel through the blood like sound waves. Its velocity is much faster than the flow of blood itself. The highest pressure during pulsation is called systolic pressure. The lowest is called diastolic pressure. And the difference between the two is pulse pressure. Mean arterial pressure is the average pressure over the period of the entire cardiac cycle. Traveling pressure pulses cause distension of the vessel wall, which can be felt from the skin. It travels faster in stiff vessels, and it progressively dampens due to compliance and resistance. Now, for sticking with me until the end, here is a bonus point for you. If you are still not able to differentiate between velocity and intensity, observe this graph of pulse pressure. In the later part, it's getting small, which means it's damping. And it's also traveling faster, due to more stiff, small arteries. I hope it finally helps. If you enjoyed this video, you will also like my other videos at nonstopneuron.com. Check them out. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.